We at Customization aim to make your Zoho experience seamless, so today we'll be showing you how to set up and customize your reports in Zoho Projects. To learn more helpful tips and tricks for your Zoho applications, consider subscribing and pressing the bell icon.
Each project in Zoho Projects has the dashboard view. Such dashboard in a project shows important progress indicators, some graphs or statistics, and other key performance indicators. You can use such information just to understand and check where the project stands. To find such dashboard view, click on the projects in the left navigation panel and then find the particular project. Navigate to dashboards in the top panel and navigate to widgets. There is the possibility to reorder or disable or enable some widgets. By clicking on the three dots, choose the Customize Widgets option and you will see the list of widgets which are available per project. Now all widgets are enabled. There is the possibility just to toggle the module and just enable and disable it. After you make some edits, click Save and the edits will be reflected on the dashboard view. There is also the simple possibility to drag and drop the widgets just to reorder them. After you dragged and dropped some widgets and created the new order, just click Save. And after that, the reordering will be visible and reflected on the dashboard view. Moving forward, there is the percentage of completion on the project. And such percentage in such way is calculated based on the count of completed tasks and issues per project. So if there is zero completion percentage per project, in such case, we can assume that there are no completed tasks and issues and all tasks and issues are opened. Let's start with widgets review. There are three types of widgets which cover the progress on worked items. And there are task status, issue status, and milestone status widgets. Such widgets show the amount of open and closed work items like tasks, issues, and milestones. There is the possibility to refresh the widget. Also, there is the possibility to choose to click on the by icon in the top right corner and change the widget chart type to bar chart or donut chart. And you have the possibility to change the chart type on each chart on the dashboard view. Moving forward, there are some performance indicators like team status, top 5, go-getters or issue fixers. Team status widget shows us the users per project and also the amount of overdue tasks or issues, today's tasks or issues which are assigned to some user, and also some open tasks and all open issues under some user. The top 5 go-getters widget shows us the top 5 users with the maximum amount of completed tasks. Top 5 issue fixers widget shows top 5 users per project which have maximum amount of issues which are fixed. There are also some reports and summary charts, and there is the plenty of such widgets which are related to such classification. There is the task progress chart, weekly digest, task planned versus actual, profitability summary and timesheet summary. Let's start with task progress chart widget. This widget shows us the task count against a specific completion percentage. So by hovering over the shaded columns on the chart, you can see the amount of tasks against their completion percentage. There is also the possibility to change the chart type from bar chart to pie, donut and area chart. The weekly digest gets the status of tasks, task lists, milestones, and issues per project and per some week. You can choose the week by clicking on the drop-down and choose the particular week based on which you want to track the performance. There is also the possibility to Select the different view from the lot in the upper right part of the widget and change the chart to bar, line, area, and scatter. Task planned versus actual widget shows us the planned amount of task, planned amount of hours, which are calculated from the work hours field on the task. The actual or overrun hours, they are calculated based on the time logs of all users which are added under some particular project. The profitability summary dashboard shows us profitability summary based on this fiscal year, or there are also possibility to choose the summary on previous fiscal year, last 12 months or last 6 months. There is also the option to find the filtering, to arrange the filtering, whether it's accrual or cash. The profitability summary will not be empty if you have integrated Zoho Books or Zoho Inventory to Zoho Projects and you create some invoices or you use expenses which are integrated with Zoho Projects. In such case, you will see such profitability summary. The timesheet summary tracks the billable and non-billable hours which were logged by the team. And there are also pipeline work items indicators. The today's work item widget shows us the list of work items which are scheduled for current day. The upcoming shows us the amount of work items which are scheduled for current week. The overdue work items shows us the work items which due date is overdue. And there is the upcoming events widget. There is the possibility to schedule the event by clicking on the schedule event button. And also this upcoming event widget shows us the events which are scheduled for the current week. And to finalize with, there is the tags widget. And by hovering on some tags which are added on the tasks for the project, you can track the amount of tasks which are assigned with such widgets. So here the test widget is assigned only to one task and test tag is assigned also to one task. Thank you.
That was an easy to follow tutorial on how to set up your widgets and customize your reports in Zoho Projects. Help us grow our community. Hit like, subscribe, and share this video to people you know. Do you have questions or clarifications? Send them our way at knowhow@customization.ca.